The name of this video is Parallel Plate Capacitor Force Open. In this video, in fact, we are going to solve the very same problem of the previous video, isolated, but assuming that the walls of the capacitor are always connected to a battery. Therefore, the system is open, charge can go on the plates, maintaining the potential of the plates always the same. Let us resketch quickly this scenario, just looking at the capacitor from this side for simplicity in this case. So this is one wall of the capacitor with area capital A and charge plus Q as always. The other wall is at the distance capital D from the first wall. I'm just doing the same cross section like A. The distance here between the two walls is capital D, not to confuse it again with small d differential in the z-axis. This plate is charged with charge minus Q. Definition of capacitor. And here we have the z-axis, which goes from here to the right. This is our z-axis. This time, however, I maintain these two plates always connected to a battery. Let me sketch it just with this symbol here. Plus, minus, in this fashion. So the system is therefore open. Charge can move on this plate. So what is constant? The potential difference delta V. Okay, we want to compute in these open conditions the force, which can only be along the z-axis, Fz magnitude, between these two plates upon displacing one of the two plates, let's say the negatively charged one to the right, by quantity Tz to the right, infinitesimal displacement, which again will correspond in a change in capacitance. However, in this case, we are considering an open system, so the result is plus the partial derivative becomes the total derivative with respect to z, the only variable we have at hand in this case. Again, pause the video and think, between the two possible electrostatic energies for this capacitor, which one would you use in the open system? Q squared over 2c or 1 half c delta b squared? Well, clearly, since we are considering an open circuit, we are going to consider here. So we need to compute this for UE at constant V. Since V is constant, this is going to be plus the derivative with respect to Z of this energy for V constant. The one we want to use in this case is simply 1 half C the capacitance delta V quantity squared. Like this. Great. Because V is constant. Subscript, this means constant. Let us remind again ourselves what is the capacitance associated with this object when the distance between the plates is D, is epsilon naught A divided by capital D. What is sigma? Is the total charge Q on the positive plate divided by A. At least this is plus sigma. Great. With all these definitions now, let us compute this quantity here. So how do we compute this quantity here? Well, we bring the z, as always, to the left-hand side here. And so we're going to find it that fz magnitude times dz is going to be equal to, remember that this is plus sign when the open system we're considering, because we have the energy of the external batteries, of the external sources, which are the batteries, which is 2 times the internal energy, but that gets a minus sign, so the overall is a plus sign. See the theory video on that. So dz, we bring it there. So here we have the full differential with the positive sign in this case of this quantity. Delta V, we are in this condition, is constant, so we can take it outside. So we get 1 half delta B quantity square. What about C? C changes, and so we have the differential of C again, the C of the capacitance. The Z we brought it to the other side, 1/2 delta V square are constant because we are considering an open system. What is DC? Well, let me remind you that from the previous video, DC from Taylor series is given by minus epsilon naught A divided by capital D quantity square times DZ. So we want to plug in this into this equation here. As such, therefore obtaining FZ DZ. Now I pick a minus sign from this definition, from this DC here. So I have minus 1/2 quantity delta V square, minus 1/2 delta V square, minus we took it. Then I have epsilon naught A, so minus we already have it there, epsilon A divided by D square times dz, dz and dz cancel out, both of them, as always, as in the previous case. Now, what we want to do next, we want to multiply this quantity, we want to multiply and divide by epsilon naught A at first. So by multiplying and dividing by epsilon A, this gives us an epsilon naught A square divided by D square. What is that? Epsilon naught A square divided by D square, this is nothing but C square. So we can rewrite this as FZ equal minus 1/2. All this quantity epsilon naught A times epsilon naught A divided by D square is actually C square times delta B quantity square. So we get minus 1/2, delta V quantity square, then we took care already of this epsilon naught, another epsilon naught divided by D square, so we have everything up until here, but then we have divided by epsilon naught A. Great. So now the next thing we want to do, we want to remember our definition of capacitance in general. So I remind you that capacitance in general, we know the C is Q divided by delta B. Therefore, Q is C delta B. C squared delta B squared is nothing but Q squared. So I'm using this in here. So this one is nothing but C delta B squared, which is Q squared. And then let us multiply and divide by A, so we can use this equation here as well, Q over A. All right, so then what we get that FZ is equal to minus 1/2. This is Q square, this quantity here is Q square, divided by these two A's, A square, which are this, I'm taking this A, with this quantity, these two A's with this quantity. So what I'm left with, so I already took into account this, I'm left with an A over epsilon naught, which finally we can rewrite Q square over A square is Q over A, which is sigma square, so it's sigma square, so it's minus sigma square divided by two epsilon naught minus sigma square divided by 2 epsilon naught times A. And as I said before, typically people like to renormalize this FZ over the area A of the plate. This gives us minus sigma square divided by 2 epsilon naught. So we get minus sigma square divided by 2 epsilon naught, which is exactly the same result we found in the previous video, where we consider the system to be, in that case, isolated. So we had, in that case, here, in that case, we had U, E, and Q. So in these two different cases, we get the same result, which is as expected. This very clearly showing the role of these canonical variables Q and V. If I use V, as in this case, I'm considering effectively an open system, and I get this result. If I consider Q, I'm considering actually an isolated system, and I get the same result. It's not to be surprised that the force is the same, because it's the same force between the two plates. I think this is the most pedagogical and better way to actually explain this role of dual variables Q and V, which I think is very interesting from the scientific point of view, and also in applications later on, it comes up everywhere. So to summarize all these four videos about the forcing conductors, first of all, we consider in general the theory with two videos. The first video was a generic system of conductors, Kelvin conductors, isolated globally and locally, which means Q is constant. Q is constant, we found a certain result for F of R in general, in this case Z, because it's the example, right? Second video, same system of generic conductors, but in that case, the system was open, that is, the conductors were attached to batteries so that the potential is constant. So either Q or V are constant. And we found a result, a theoretical result, which has a plus sign in the derivative instead of a minus sign. Then we have done an example using both these methods for the simple parallel plate capacitor, for which we know everything, capacitance, etc. First, we use the method where we have minus the derivative, in this case, with respect to Z of UEQ, and then plus derivative with respect to Z of UEV, constant Q, constant V. In the first case, we use as energy for the capacitors Q squared over 2C, variable Q. In this case, we use 1/2 CV squared delta V squared, variable delta V, so V. We obtain the same result, which normalized over A is minus sigma squared over 2 epsilon naught. That's it.